Have you ever wondered what it would be like to play Portal, but instead of a portal gun, you're holding a flashlight? And instead of portals, everything is like really dark unless you shine a light on it? And instead of being teleported when stepping into the shadows, you die? Well, you're basically playing a totally different game at that point, but what if, instead of having a snarky robot telling you that you're stupid, you have an arrogant CEO doing it? Well, I guess that last part is pretty much the same. Anyways, now you're thinking with Lightmatter. Lightmatter is the debut title of Danish game developer Tunnel Vision Games and was released back in January this year. It is a first-person puzzle game that somehow sends your mind straight to Portal, even though it resembles games like the Talos Principle much more in terms of actual gameplay. But whenever I get distinct Portal vibes from a new puzzle game, I'm always like... Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. Maybe it's because the core mechanic of Lightmatter is so unique and simple, just like that of the Portal games. Stay in the light and don't touch the shadows. Granted, the devs did mention that they were inspired by the mechanics of Closure, a 2D puzzle game from 2012, but it still seems like an overlooked concept. And anything that can blow some life into the first-person puzzle game genre, well, they get all the thumbs up from me. If they're done well, of course. Spoiler alert, Lightmatter is done well. And I'm not just saying that because I know the developers in real life. With Lightmatter, Tunnel Vision Games have managed to make a core gameplay loop that, even though it's really simple, can also be really hard to master and wrap your head around, which I think is thanks to some overall really great level design. The puzzles are fun, which really is what matters the most. I mean, what do you have if you don't know how to make fun puzzles for your puzzle game? That's like trying to make a funny video game review, but you have no idea about how to write jokes. There's plenty of aha moments when you finally figure out a puzzle, which is something that always feels great. Woo! That coupled with only a few really frustrating ones, which was funnily enough the ones where I got stuck.
So a bit here, I guess. I guess that's fine. It's not about accuracy, is what Wixo said. It's about brain power, of which we of course have none.
Makes for some very successful level design in my book. But it's not all fun and puzzles, there's also an amazing atmosphere in Lightmatter and a great story to boot. Lightmatter features a great soundtrack to immerse you into a really cool setting and amazing aesthetics. I gotta say, I really adore the dark comic book art style that, together with the soundtrack, gave me a thriller-like vibe that reminded me of games such as Bioshock. And there's plenty of environmental storytelling to go around, which makes the world feel alive and like an actual place. Lightmatter also features amazing voice acting, which I think is rather rare for an indie title.
Unbelievable. There's more of you.
Virgil, the villain and eccentric CEO of Lightmatter Technologies, is voiced by David Bateson in the English version of the game.
But I need you to pay attention. First off, walk through that door.
And Lars Mikkelsen is voicing the Danish Virgil.
Strålende. Du har allerede overgået mine forventninger.
So if you understand both English and Danish, you have an awesome option of receiving snarky comments about your own lacking intelligence by either Agent 47 of the Hitman series.
Now I presume you know how buttons work.
Or from Stregobor from Netflix's The Witcher series.
Så dygtig. Med den indsats burde jeg høre dig til at vaske gulvet.
And let's not forget Natalie Hitzel, who does a great job as Ellen, the employee of Lightmatter Technologies, who finds her own worldview crumbling the further into the story that we get.
People are still losing hair and now fingernails. It doesn't make any sense.
Talking about the story gives you a reason for why you're actually doing the puzzles in the first place. Navigating the, oh, you're just gonna do puzzles because this is a puzzle game pitfall that I feel like games in this genre can very easily fall into. The result is a die-hard-like scenario where you find yourself in the wrong place at the wrong time, just trying to get yourself out of the Lightmatter Technologies facility before it's too late.
Come out to the coast, we'll get together, have a few laughs.
Guiding you through your journey towards the exit is Virgil, the extremely intelligent and arrogant CEO. Now, I really like the character of Virgil because while he's very clearly the villain of the Lightmatter story, you can definitely also understand his motivations for doing what he's doing. You know, he just took a couple of wrong turns here and there, and then a couple of more, and then, well, then a couple of more, I guess. Virgil is also the kind of character who absolutely knows that he's brilliant, and he just loves telling it to everyone who wants to listen, or anyone who, as in the case of Lightmatter, doesn't have a choice but to listen because Virgil is working the speaker system of the facility.
And this living, breathing monument to science still stands.
We all know someone of this type, you know, the ones who really love the sound of their own voice. And I think that makes Virgil and his frequent intermissions believable and not just a tool for exposition. Virgil is also quite funny in the derogatory GLaDOS-like way, you know, thinking the player to be stupid and beneath him. And Virgil really enjoys nothing more than to throw more or less hidden insults your way as the player, which is something that I really liked.
Try using the right side of your brain. If you have one.
Speaking of GLaDOS and the Portal universe, Tunnel Vision Games were actually in touch with Valve, who agreed to have Lightmatter exist in the same universe as the Portal series, which I think is so cool. This also means that there are multiple references as to what's going on around the same time at Aperture Science, which for a Portal lover like me, really got me smiling from ear to ear.
It succeeded, but the first iterations of that recipe used neurotoxin as the primary ingredient. As a human being, I'm worried.
That is so cool.
I also feel like the story really hits the sweet spot in length, where it left me wanting more, while also ending at the right time so that it didn't feel too long, like, for example, the Talos principle did.
When the sun hits that ridge just right, these hills sing.
Well, that settles it.
But it's not all robot unicorns, rainbows, and erasure singing always. I do have some cons in opposition to what turned out to be a very strong pros list. If we start out with some technical aspects of Lightmatter, the shader used to make the killer shadows sometimes make for some very rough and really pixelated edges that do bring the immersion down a little bit when you start to notice them. I also in my playthrough experienced a bug where I think I completely bypassed a level because the shadows suddenly didn't kill me, which was a real shame. To this end, it should be noted that I played on version 1.02 all the way back in January, and the game has been patched multiple times since then and is now in version 1.09, so presumably bugs like those have been fixed by now.
Have I done something wrong?
There's also the fact that Lightmatter has a limited set of solutions for the puzzles, where there's often just one way to solve them. The developers were kind enough to give a detailed answer to this in their Reddit Ask Me Anything around release, where they explained that it was actually a design decision. Having, for example, the lamps only be 360 degrees of horizontal placement just made for a more controllable environment with much, much less variables when designing the actual puzzles. And Tunnel Vision Games were, as a new player in the field of game making, much more comfortable with this approach, which is something I can totally, totally respect. This also leaves room for expanding the different mechanics when making a sequel. Just saying.
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge.
However, having a limited set of solutions for the puzzles does limit the actual replayability of Lightmatter, since you've already done everything the way it's meant to be done, and you can't make challenges like they did, for example, in Portal 1, which had stuff like finish this puzzle in 4 steps or less.
Now that you are in control of both portals, this next test could take a very, very long time.
Lightmatter does try to compensate for this by having secrets littered out through the game, and as well as a secret ending, which is something that's always cool, I think. Ah! 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 We found Lux!
You know, Lux looks up to me.
Speaking of the end, and I'm just gonna put a giant minor spoiler tag on now so you can skip the next bit if you want to. It was also one of the things that I didn't quite like. Not story-wise, but rather mechanics-wise. The ending of Lightmatter makes the game turn from a puzzle game to something more reminiscent of a timed platformer, which I feel like was a little bit of a shame. I realized that there's need for a climax in the story, which the end did deliver, since it actually became quite hectic at times, but I would have preferred it to be somehow using the puzzle mechanics learned throughout the game. Instead, the ending is pretty much just running and jumping through the levels before the encroaching shadows eat you alive. So, with the bad sides out of the way, here we are, at the conclusion you've all been waiting for. Whether or not I think Lightmatter should take your money. And oh my god, yes, it definitely should. Especially if you're a fan of puzzle games or the Portal franchise. And even if you aren't, I still think you should at least give Lightmatter a go, because you can actually play about the first hour of the game for free. Lightmatter as a whole is an impressive debut title from a small indie game developer. It delivers a great and topical story centered around renewable energy, with a memorable villain whose motivations are actually understandable, all wrapped in an atmospheric, dark comic book environment, with an innovative core mechanic that is easy to learn but hard to master.
Ooh. No.
It's not the longest game in the world, but it's certainly not the shortest either, and I had loads of fun playing it. And adding in the free to try option, I don't see any reason why you're still sitting here listening to me talk about Lightmatter.
I'm simply at peace. Finally.